Today we are going to learn how to create web pages. No, I'm not going to teach you any programming or HTML or CSS. I'm going to show you how easy it is to create a web page. Let's look at this one which I created. I have a web page with photos. I scroll, it goes to the next page. It's a stack of photos. I click and it moves. Beautiful. Now I want to show you before after. So there was a jungle and then it was replaced with a skyline. All this I created in few minutes without knowing anything about programming, hosting, web servers, links, nothing. And how was this possible? Using an amazingly brilliant product called Sway. Surprisingly, this has always been there as a part of Office 365 for at least a decade. So go to Office 365, click on the 9 dots waffle menu, look at it, Sway. Obvious question is, what do you use it for? And that answer comes right away, because as soon as you click on Sway, it shows you templates. Look at the names of the templates, you will know the reasons why people use it. It can be a quick circular, announcement, standard operating procedure, user manual, newsletter. Sky is the limit. Now, how do you create it? That's the next question. The easiest way to create it is from Word. You already have a document in Word, but you don't want to send it to people. You want it to be a web page. Sure, go to File menu, Transform, choose a design. That's it. A web page is automatically created. Automatically, what does it do? Oh, it gives you a nice table of contents also like this. It allows you to customize how you want to navigate. So if you go to Settings, you will see that there are options, vertical navigation, horizontal navigation. And now you'll say, how am I going to share this? Where is it hosted? You don't bother. You just design it, click on the share button, and then just decide, is it for internal staff where people have to actually log in, only company's staff members, or is it anonymous for external customers, vendors? Choose the link type. Copy the link, send it to people. Or maybe you want to create a QR code and put it on your brochure. Whatever it is, it's done. Now you will ask me, this is good on a big screen. What if my customer is looking at it on mobile? Sure, let's simulate that. I'm going to make this smaller now and I'm going to make it like a mobile screen. Notice what happened? It's still adjusting itself beautifully. In fact, if you want to, you can decide how the scrolling also happens. Should it by default be horizontal or vertical? It's touch enabled automatically. So responsive web design. So let's quickly see how to get it done. Start from scratch. Add a title, put a picture, and then that plus sign is to add more and more content. So we are writing the story or providing the content. So you keep adding content one after another. What can you add? Text, images, video, audio, Power BI, all kinds of things. In fact, there is something called embed code, which is even more powerful because it supports so many products with embed codes. After all this is done, you want to see how it looks. Sure. So now click on the play button. When you finish looking at the preview, come back. Now you can go to the design tab. In design, what do you see? Well, in design, there are multiple options available for you to choose styles. Choose the style you like. Instantly, everything is reformatted. Beautiful. You can even create your custom style based on your branding guidelines. Now, it's done. If you want just inspiration, click on the remix button. It'll just find some good combination and give every time you click on the remix, different combination. So you choose what you like, finalize it, share it, finished. Now, while sharing, by default, you would like people to view it. But maybe you are working in a team and some people have necessity to edit it. No problem. You have an edit option as well. And finally, sometimes what happens, let's say there's a lobby or you are participating in a trade show and you have a display and you want your company profile or set of products or images of a company offsite, which recently happened, something to keep scrolling automatically. So create a Sway, go to settings, choose the timing and say run automatically. So it'll keep running like a kiosk mode. Something similar we can do in PowerPoint also, but this is so much easier. Does not need any special software, just runs out of the box. Now, so a little bit of technical stuff. Where is this data going? Where is this website? As a user, you don't have to bother, but this is a part of Office 365. the pictures, hosting, everything is a part of your Office 365 tenant. So if you look at the link, it'll be sway dot whatever, whatever. And that link will be unique to each tenant. Now you'll ask me, can I create a full-fledged website using Sway? Technically, yes. Many people have created their FAQs or standard operating procedures or reference manuals as a part of Sway. Because it's a web page, you can create multiple Sway web pages and link them to each other to create a sort of a website. Is it a proper website the way technically we think of? Not necessarily, because behind the scenes, it's doing a lot of redirection, a lot of security things. So this is not a replacement to a professionally created website. But if you want something to be created quickly without knowing anything technically and have professional look, there's nothing like Sway available. And the best part is it's free if you have Office 365. So use it whenever needed. So I'm sure you found a lot of good ideas about where you can use Sway. Try it out. Let me know in comments where you used it. And before you go, Sway is just one of the 27 tools which are a part of Office 365. I have a detailed video which tells you what each tool does and which one to use when. Have a look at it. I'm sure you'll like it. So that's it for now. See you next time. Bye-bye.